This lighting is going to kill me.
Oh, cooperate, son.
Hey, Slobby Nation, welcome back to my channel. And today I'm really excited to share with you a tutorial. I'm sitting down today because I feel like I should have a spilling the tea setup. I really liked it when I was filming in my bedroom, and I thought maybe I should keep the same vibe, you know? Sit down a little bit, not pace around so much. On Instagram stories, I asked you guys if I should wear my hair straight or wavy this week because I wash my hair once a week. A lot of you guys voted that I should keep it straight today, so straight it is. You know, for it being air dried, it's actually not so bad. Looking pretty good, right? I'm sorry, you guys. The lighting's gonna be changing quite a few times. So last week, so many of you guys asked me how I did my lashes and what kind of lashes I was wearing. And actually, these are lash extensions or lash clusters, and you just kind of stick them on and they last for a good week to 2 weeks depending on how you take care of them. So let me backtrack really quickly and tell you about my eyelashes. I do have very long and full eyelashes, so if you guys want to check out all my other videos on how I grow them out or I take care of them, what mascaras I use, I have a list of different videos down below that you guys can check out. And then I discovered lash extensions in 2011, where they go in and they adhere an individual lash extension to each one of your real natural lashes. And I did like that for a hot minute, except it ended up getting really expensive. I always had to make an appointment and I hate being there because it was an hour long. Truthfully, it was mostly about the cost of it. It got kind of expensive. So it wasn't until 2016 when I started playing with falsies again, where you just wear your falsies and you look really pretty, and it's just like, there has to be a way where I don't have to actually apply the falsies on every single day. Like, I'm gonna try this whole lash clusters things out. And many, many times before, I've done the lash clusters in my past and it has never worked out. And the reason why is because I am too dumb to read the packaging. What I was doing is I was taking the lash clusters and dipping it into the lash strip rubber glue, and then I would just adhere it to like the top of my eyelid where the skin is, just like I would with a lash strip. Apparently, that's not how you're supposed to be doing it, and that's the reason why I hated it so much, because it never looked right. It was always like wonky and sticking out weird. Turns out there's a special glue for individual lashes, and you don't just adhere it to your skin, you adhere it to your actual lashes. I hate the fact that I don't read the instructions because I always think I know better. I am clearly stupid. In August, I decided to venture into lash clusters again. I used different types of glues and I used different types of strategies and methods and different types of lashes, cheap, expensive, to just not worth it at all. You know what? I realized that I kind of got this shit down to a science. So I'm gonna kind of walk you guys through the step-by-step and tutorial on how to do it. I feel like I can tell you to dip your lashes in glue and then just apply it on, but I think there is a strategy and there is a method to my madness and my dolly lashes. Yes, so I came up with a lash diagram alongside with me actually applying it to my eyes. So first and foremost, what you'll need is your lash clusters, and I buy the Ardell Professional Individual Pack. I got this at Sally's. It's actually a 6-pack, so if you get it in bulk, it ends up being cheaper. So I buy the medium one and also the long ones. Make sure you get the knot-free ones. With the knot, I think it's too bulky, and I feel like it doesn't adhere to your lashes as well as if it were to be knot-free. For me, if you want big dolly lashes like mine, the medium and the long is really good. If you want to do more of like a wing look, then you would have to do short, medium, and long, if that makes sense. The next thing you will need is definitely tweezers. These are really, really pointy, and they're just like this, and it has a nice little grip here. Lastly, and the most important thing, is obviously the glue. The ones that I really, really, really love and super suggest, the Duo Clear Individual Lash Glue is amazing. Trust me, you guys, this is definitely the win-win here. To start off, what you want to do is you want to make sure that your eyes is super clean. Make sure that there isn't any extra oils on your eyes. If you have oils on your lashes, the lashes aren't going to adhere and stay on your eyes for a very long time. So while I'm trying to show you guys how to do this on my eye, it is very difficult to see and I can totally understand, so I have a diagram for you guys. So the next thing, what you want to do is curl your lashes. And the reason why is because when your real lashes are sticking up, it kind of gives it a little bit of support for the false lashes to adhere to it. Let's say that this is your eye right here and all of your lashes are kind of just sticking down. So you can go ahead and take a lash curler and just curl it up really quickly. So you know how you're watching makeup tutorials and they tell you to curl your lashes as close to the root and then the middle and then the tip. For this tutorial, all you have to do is just curl the root. You just want it to really like stick up. I'm trying to curl my lashes, okay? So as you guys can see, these are my lashes. It's kind of straight and kind of sparse, which is okay. Asian struggles, you know? I'm going to start off by creating my base, which is by using the medium lashes first. And I think it's great for the inner corners all the way around to the outer corners. It just creates a really nice base for anything else to lay on top or underneath of it. What I do is I take my tweezers and I kind of just pull a couple of them out of their wells. And I end up just pouring the glue inside one of the wells. Let the glue sit for a little bit. I would say about 2 to 3 minutes so that it has more of a tacky consistency. You don't want it to be too wet still, because then what happens is that when the lashes is adhered to your real lashes, it kind of just droops forward a little bit. You want it to be tacky so that it has some structure to it. Another note is on the short and the medium lashes, what I've noticed is that the lashes comes with a little bit of a plasticky rubber, not so much on the longer ones. If you can, use your hands to kind of just remove some of that. The more of that you have on your lashes, it just creates bolt with the glue, with other lashes, and it ends up not looking natural. Okay, so I'm gonna zoom up really, really close where you guys can see my eye here. What you wanna do is kinda just look at your eye and reevaluate like where you have all of your gaps, if there's any places that need to be filled in. And we're gonna go ahead and move on to the next steps. Oh my gosh, my hair is being such bizarro land today, but today we're talking about my lashes. I have my lash clusters here. So what you do is you will take your lash clusters and you will hold it with a pair of tweezers. You just dip it into the well of glue and you pick it right up. Once you dip it into the well, there's gonna be glue on both sides. And to give it a very clean and precise application, I just like to wipe the lashes onto the edge of the plastic so that only the glue is on one side or the other. So when it comes to these medium ones, what I like to do is I like to actually apply them right onto my real lashes, but underneath. There's two ways to do it. You can go underneath or you can go right on top, but I think going underneath is a little bit better because the curl of the medium lashes will help push up your real lashes. So even if it's no longer curled, at least it's being pushed up by the medium ones. So I'm gonna use my hot glue gun here, which will mimic the lash glue. So just like how I applied the glue with the hot glue gun, make sure that the glue is just on top here. And what you'll do is you'll just stick it to one of your lashes like that. What you're gonna do is you're gonna continue to do that. You're gonna kind of give it like a good 1/8 to 1/4 of an inch gap. If you do them too close together, what happens is that if this one decides to lean over, it's gonna take the other ones down as well. You want to give each one of them some space and some room to dry and to really find itself in the root of your lashes. For me, I personally like to work on both eyes at the same time. So once I put one lash on this eye, I would switch over to this eye and then I just transition back and forth. It gives the glue some time to dry, but at the same time, you're not stressing out with one eye constantly. This looks not so great. So I have all this looks so horrible. So you have all of your medium lashes on. Now the next step is you're supposed to go in and notice that obviously there are some gaps. You can go in and fill up the gaps with more medium lashes. I usually go in and I fill up the gaps with long lashes. You're going to dip your lashes into your glue. Make sure you wipe off the bottom because you don't want any excess. Again, you'll find another lash and you just stick it at the bottom like that. Cool beans. This is like beauty and DIY together, and I'm just so enjoying it. Again, you dip your lashes into the well of your glue and then you just find a gap or a lash that doesn't have a lash attached to it and you stick it. Boom, shika bow wow. And then you just keep repeating that all the way through. Wow, this looks horrible. There you are. Your lashes are fully and completely done. One last tip I want to give you guys is that you can obviously apply your lashes on top here. And I like to do it with the long ones. I feel like the long ones would end up sandwiching some of the middle ones and also some of your real lashes as well to give it a better protection. And so to do that, instead of placing the glue on top of here, you'll place the glue on the bottom. This is a little bit harder to do just because your lashes is already curled up, but if you kind of look down, adhere as closely as you can to your lash line onto another lash. So that, just try to find a little lash that you can just stick it on top, just like that. But once you're done, this is what your lashes will end up looking like, and it will stay like this for actually a week or two. You can either remove it all completely after the week or two, and there is an Ardell lash remover. I will put a picture of it here and link it down below. I forgot to bring it with me. Or you can just go in every single week and just refill the ones that has fallen out, because obviously your lashes grows in cycles, and so some of them are just gonna fall out naturally on their own, and the lashes that is adhered to those natural lashes will also come off with it. So that's it. That's how I get my long, pretty, and beautiful Dolly lashes. I hope you guys find this tutorial to be very easy. If you guys have any extra questions, make sure you check out the part two of this video. If not, you can just go ahead and dive right in and go for it, girl. So if you're gonna try this tutorial out, definitely shoot me a photo once you're done using the hashtag HeyKL or SLOABN to any one of my social medias, because I would love to take a look at it. If you guys like this video, be sure to like it down below, share with everyone that you know, and of course, do me a huge solid by subscribing. And I know a lot of you guys are not getting any of my videos, so if you want, you can hit on the notification bell down there. If you don't, that's fine too. My feelings won't be hurt. Anyways, that's it for now. If you guys want to mosey on over to part two, I have that linked down below, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye! You just do this the whole time to flick it out. Does it look dark? Okay, this one looks a lot better than this one, but I don't know if it's just because it's lighting.